Both Secretary of State John Kerry and Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu have been taking turns defending their positions.
Ronald Reagan negotiated with the former Soviet Union. Richard Nixon negotiated with what was then known as Red China. You have to negotiate sometimes with people to make the world and your country safer. And we negotiated because President Obama thought the primary challenge here was getting a nuclear weapon away from Iran, and we believe this deal does that.
There was a celebrated deal just a few years ago, a nuclear deal. Everybody, the scientific community, the international community, everybody applauded it. It was a deal with North Korea. That proved to be a historic mistake as well. And North Korea today has a dozen nuclear bombs and is on track to get, within a few years, 100 nuclear bombs. So I think that this is a repeat of the mistake of North Korea.
The clock began on the 60-day period for Congress to review the agreement. However, the Obama administration is planning to take the accord to the UN Security Council before Congress can vote. While Kerry and Netanyahu staked out their positions and Congress reviews the accord, crowds in Tehran shouted death to America. Supreme Leader Ayatollah Khamenei vowed Iran's policy toward what he called the arrogant United States would not change and pledged to support its jihadist allies in the region. With billions of dollars in sanctions relief, many Middle East observers fear Iran will soon be able to resupply the terror groups Hezbollah, Hamas, and the regime of Syrian President Bashar Assad. In the meantime, as one more sign of the growing tensions in the region, 47% of Israelis would support a unilateral strike against Iran's nuclear program. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.